Okay guys, here's a new video on our channel. The topic today is the active track ability of the DJI Mini 3 Pro, which can be started in the DJI Fly app. This ability allows you to fly your drone autonomously. It will then always follow the previously selected object. The sensors are also used to ensure that there are no collisions. Remember, the drone has forward, backward and downward sensors. There are two different active track capabilities, namely the regular follow mode and the parallel mode. I use both in this intro. With the latter, the DJI Mini 3 Pro always stays next to the object. This creates great perspectives. The big disadvantage, as just mentioned, is that the drone has no sideways facing sensors. With this method, you have to make sure that there are no obstacles. In this video, we show you how to activate and use this function in the DJI Fly app. We also make a small comparison with a slightly older model, the Mavic Pro Platinum. So stay tuned and have fun. If you like what you see, then subscribe. Okay, now I'll show you how to enable active track on your DJI Mini 3 Pro. The function is somewhat hidden and is therefore not always found immediately. But you will see that the handling is very simple. First, we select the video recording function on the right side. Leave the settings on normal. Then use your finger to drag a band on the display over the object. In our case, the car that is to be tracked by the drone. A short sample video now appears in the Fly app when it is used for the first time. Below this, three new buttons will appear. From here, select the button on the far left, which is called Active Track. Now press the green Go button. The drone will now switch to Active Track mode. Alright, let's go then. The text overlays only appear the first time. It's hard to see here in the video because there are two more buttons behind it. We'll see that later. As you can see, the drone hangs directly on the back of our car. It stays roughly at the altitude at which we configured it. Slightly changes can be caused by obstacles or weather conditions. You can stop this at any time by pressing the red stop button. So as mentioned, there's a second really useful function, namely the one where the DJI Mini 3 Pro moves sideways parallel to the object. To activate this, an object to be tracked must be for sure selected again. So you can imagine that it is important to place the aircraft parallel to the side of the object beforehand. Then select the active track button again in the lower area. In this example, you can now clearly see the two selectable options above, which is follow and parallel. Now select parallel. An info box now appears in the Fly app indicating that obstacle detection is not available because there are no sight sensors. Next, select Go and the function is active. Let's give it a try and get going. As you can see, the drone moves exactly parallel to the vehicle and thus offers an exceptional point of view. The drone is by no means static, but makes slightly movements. These can be seen very clearly here. This creates a pleasant dynamic of the video footage. The software works quite confidently and is not disturbed by other objects that come into the picture. As long as you don't drive faster than about 45 km per hour, which is approximately 28 miles per hour, the drone will always stay on your side. Here are a few tests that may be useful. Let's start with a speed test. On the current video, we drive about 40 km per hour, which is around 25 miles per hour. You can see that the drone can track the vehicle well. Let's increase a little bit the speed to around 80 km per hour, which is around 50 miles per hour. The drone reaches its speed limit and the vehicle moves away. Nevertheless, the drone does not lose focus on the object, even if it's very far away and difficult to see, as it is the case here. We now break back down to about 20 km per hour, which is around 70 miles per hour, and observe how the aircraft will behave. Constantly, almost stoically, she flies on and on until she has reached the focus object again. Even in these difficult lightning conditions, there are apparently no problems. We would summarize pretty good. So in the next test, we want to know what happens when the direct line of sight to the focus object is disturbed. To do this,
we simply drive under a tree. The line of sight does not break off completely, but is severely restricted. We can see that the drone loses focus, but picks it up again shortly after and continues flying without any problems. Let's look at a similar situation from the flyer perspective. Here we can see that the focus box is briefly lost as the car is partially obscured by the power pole. Instead, a spot behind the car seems to be focused. When the car comes back into full line of sight, the focus box reappears and the drone resumes its work with no problem. In the last situation, we combine the two cases from before at a lower altitude. We first fly over a tree that partially covers our vehicle. As expected, it briefly loses focus, but picks it up again shortly afterwards. The same with the second tree. But with the third tree, the line of sight to the focus object is completely lost for a short time. The drone fails to regain focus shortly after stopping over the tree instead. Here we have obviously pushed the aircraft and the software to their limits. In this test, we want to know what happens if you don't select an active track in the focus menu. Yeah, but that's pretty simple. The drone will still focus on the selected object and track it only visually. This means that it remains in the corresponding position and does not move vertically or horizontally. A few weeks ago, we recharged the old Mavic Pro Platinum to do active track tests. The road is the same and the lightning conditions are similar. Only the drone had to contend with more leaves on the branches of the trees. But if we compare it with the Mini 3 Pro, we can't determine any loss of focus, especially in the first two trees. Only at the third tree, when the line of sight was completely interrupted, the drone had to give up. Even though this drone from 2019 does not have a parallel flight function, the tracking mode is still impressive. Even in the difficult lightning conditions, it does not lose focus. Not even if the vehicle accelerates faster and the distance to the drone increases. As we saw with the Mini 3 Pro, it keeps chasing until it has reduced the distance again and arrived at the focus object. In summary, these machines still do a good job. If you have a DJI Mini 2 and still want to take focus shots even though it doesn't have active track, there's a little trick. Select circle from the quick shots and let the drone circle in the same direction as the focus object is moving. If you like the video, smash a like button, drop me a comment below and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye bye.